Yeah, we are going to see the body of a broadcast news story. You will be familiar with the print news news story structure. That is the inverted pyramid structure. And let me give you a few advantages of that inverted pyramid structure. As you all know, the facts are presented in descending order. So descending order of importance and inverted pyramid structure. After each sentence or a paragraph, the reader can leave the story or having gleaned an increasingly detailed sense of what happened. So there they have the freedom of leaving the story. Also, print editors can cut the story almost anywhere, knowing that the most important information has already been presented. This is the biggest advantage. That is why, because as far as print media is concerned, we all know that space is important. So editors, they can easily delete or edit the last paragraph of the news story. That's why they prefer inverted pyramid style structure. And coming to this broadcast style, in its actually first two decades, radio news did not have a broadcast style. News writing and presentation were in newspaper style in the beginning time. And Mr. Edward R. Murrow, one of the legendary news readers during the war period, he gave radio news a style of its own. And Murrow's broadcast from London during German air raids stand even today as models of the art of broadcast reporting. So in broadcast news, every sentence of a story is important, because when listeners leave the story, they are usually leaving the newscast. So this is the difference. So in addition, listeners generally cannot digest a lot of information all at once. So broadcast stories are short compared to print media stories. Every sentence needs to be heard. Stories need to be tight with no extraneous information or loose ends. Although the most important information is given first, what follows is also important. And sometimes facts are presented in descending order of importance, like print media, and sometimes in chronological order, like a narrative format. So it depends according to the story. Overall, you know, sentences or broadcast news sentences are shorter and contain fewer facts than those used in print stories. And moving to the next slide. So descending order of importance. What is this descending order of importance? That is, you know, the broadcast journalist must first figure out the most significant piece of information to tell the listeners. And it goes in a story's lead. So they have to first find out the most significant piece of information which goes into a story's lead. Then the journalist must anticipate what else listeners want to know. So this is the second point. This information makes up the body of the story. So although a story may contain several pieces of information, their order is usually dictated by the facts given in the lead. If the lead indicates that a minister was killed last night, example, okay, if the lead indicates that a minister was killed last night, listeners will want to know the victim's name. So they will also want to know where, how, and why the victim was killed. And they will want to know what police are doing about the case. I believe you can follow this order. So first is, print media style of writing. Lead must answer WH questions, all WH questions, which, where, why, what, when, and one, how. So here, broadcast lead cannot give answer to all these five WH questions in the beginning. That is the basic difference. Please understand. Broadcast lead cannot give answers to all these WH questions. If the lead indicates, example, that a minister was killed last night, listeners will want to know the victim's name in the beginning.